Hi guys, it's Lizzie from the Academy team, and I've had my eye on the Canon EOS RP for quite a while now. In fact, ever since Mike wouldn't let me be in our first look video last year. I've finally got hands on with it, and I have got the 24-105mm STM kit, and I'm really excited to go and take some photos. Now there are tons of full spec videos online. Like I mentioned, we've even got one too on our channel.
Run by the Digic 8 processor. It has an ISO range native of 40,000, expandable up to 102,400.
So go check that out. The link is in the description below. But what we didn't do, and what a lot of them haven't done, is really put the camera through its paces to see what quality images and video we can get. And that is exactly what I'm going to do today. People are always telling me how beautiful Bath is as a city, and although I come here quite a lot, I've never really fully explored. So I figured today, why not get out? Why not look for some street-ish architectural style of subjects to photograph? And I have wandered to the very iconic Royal Crescent. So I'm gonna test out the wide angle on this lens here, so the 24mm, and just see how much of this crescent-shaped building I can fit into my shot. Now the great thing about the Canon RP is not only do I have an OLED viewfinder, but I also have a nice vari-angled flip screen on here too. Touchscreen to either take the photo or to focus. So great thing about this is it's been quite muddy recently, quite rainy. So as long as I can tilt the screen up and get the shot that I want, it means I don't need to get muddy knees or bend down or anything awkward like that. So it actually does look quite a nice shot just from hip level. I can just tap to take my photo. Worst circus ever. This is just casual. So what you found here is a kind of a narrow kind of walkway, streety pathway. I would say it's a cobbled street, but it's not cobbled. But we have a building right on the corner here, which has got quite a nice sharp edge to it. Great thing about this building is it's nice sandy on the front and actually a really dark wall on the back as well. And where the light's hitting, it casts a good shadow on it too. So I've just been using, again, the wide angle with a very angled screen, touch to move my focus points as well, just so that I can capture the kind of nice contrast between the light and the dark. I've actually really been enjoying using this setup today. It is not as weighty as I thought it might be. The 24-105mm EF-STM lens is beautifully versatile. And yes, it's not an L lens. Yes, it's not the native one for the camera, but I've also got the mount adapter on here too to convert it to R mount. And I don't really feel as though I'm carrying any extra weight at all. And that's all down to the size of the body. Probably one of the smallest full frame cameras that you could get your hands on. Not an issue to do one-handed, whereas when I used to shoot Canon full frame, there's a whole lot of bags, a whole lot of weight that I had to carry around with me. This, massively nice, massively small, massively versatile. Well, quite a nice, again, street view, which is what I seem to be finding quite a lot of in Bath, but the light is just coming in, hitting the tower just there, and also the bottom of this tower and these buildings here as well, so it's lighting up quite nicely again, good contrast. And also probably a pretty good way to test how far you can zoom in or crop in on your image once you've taken it too, just to really see what detail you can really get out of this 26.2 megapixel full frame dual pixel AF sensor. We'll be right back. Not only has this been my first time shooting with the EOS RP, but also using the 24-105mm STM lens too. I have previously used the 24-105mm L series, which I absolutely used to adore when I shot on Canon. But I can honestly say I can see why so many people are choosing this lens as an option now as well. For me, I've been so pleasantly surprised with the results that I've been getting today, not only from the camera, but also what this lens can do. When it comes to video recording, the Canon EOS RP will shoot in 4K. So I'm gonna record some of the stuff of the river and this mini waterfall potentially in 4K 25, see how that looks. And then I'm also gonna shoot it in full HD at 50 as well. These low light shots have been where this entire kit has really surprised me. The ISO performance has been absolutely fantastic, and I guess where I'm probably most shocked has been the video capabilities of this camera, especially during the low light clips that we've been filming. Now, I feel as though this camera is probably slightly underappreciated, and it could well be that people haven't just had the opportunity or the time to be able to fully put it through its paces, but I am definitely a fan. Now there is one more thing that I'll add on the lens, and that is, yes, it's not the native lens to this camera, it is an EF lens. But have I noticed that I've been having to use this adapter all day? No, it is solid, there's no movement going on there, and it doesn't really add any huge size difference either. So if you've been looking at full frame, you've maybe been looking at the 60, the EOS RP should definitely be a contender for you. If you'd like to find out any more information on the Canon EOS RP 24-105mm STM kit, then head over to jessops.com now, or pop into your nearest store where one of our experts will be more than happy to help. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. If you have, then give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and smash that bell icon so you can stay up to date on all of our latest content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.